Hello friends, I am your APN sir and you are watching my YouTube channel APN's Educreations. The motto of this channel is quality education must be free to all. This free educational content is sponsored by Competitive Point Berhampur and Seva English Medium School Tikawali. If you are a student of class 10 of Board of Secondary Education Odisha, then definitely watch this video. It is in your course. If you are a student of plus 2 of Council of Higher Secondary Education Odisha, then you also watch the video without fail. At last, if you are a student preparing for competitive exams, then this video is a must. But before you watch this video, I strongly recommend you to watch my last videos on this topic, that is subject-verb agreement. In this video, I am going to discuss some rules that govern subject-verb agreement. Watch the videos till end and write your responses in the comment section. Believe me, learning these rules will greatly help you become exact in your writing and speaking. Now let us come to the first rule. Students often commit mistakes when sentences with introductory here or there are used. Let us take two sentences. The first sentence is, there comes the buses. And the second one is, there come the buses. Which sentence will be the right one? Comes or come? In the given situation, there come the buses is the grammatically correct sentence. In the given sentences, the subject of the sentence is not the introductory there. The real subject of the sentence is the buses. As the subject, the buses is in plural, it will take the plural verb come, not comes. Now I give you two fill in the blank type questions. There, there's a book on the table. Options for you are each or are. The second one is there, there's three books on the table. Options are is and are. In the first question, the correct option will be is, because the subject, a book, is in singular form. But in the second sentence, the option will be are, as the subject is three books. The bottom line is, when sentences like these start with the words like there or here, the form of verbs should be determined carefully after determining the real subject. Rule number two. When two subjects are joined by the connective and the verb is plural, we say, Gopal has come. But we say, Gopal and his sister have come. Mark out the verb. We used have. Mark out the verb. We used have. It is not has. The plural form of the verb has, that is have. The plural form of the verb has is have. And it is used because in this sentence the subject Gopal and his sister becomes a plural subject. That's why we have used have and we have not used has in this case. English language has many exceptions. There are also some exceptions to the said rule. When two singular subjects which are joined by and together refer to a single idea, the verb is singular. The combination of subjects by and is not treated as plural subject. Some examples, bread and butter is my favorite breakfast. Bread and butter, although joined by and, is considered as a single dish, and for that reason it is not treated as plural subject. So we used is as the verb instead of are. Similarly, we say truth and honesty is the best policy. Curry and rice is my favorite dish. When two singular subjects are particularly synonymous to each other, we treat them as a singular subject, although they are joined by an. For example, we say, his power and influence is on the decline. The word power is added to influence by and, but as the two words are synonymous, we take them as a singular subject, and hence we use the verb is instead of are. Rule number 3. When a plural number applies to distance, time, weight, or amounts of money and represents a single figure or quantity, it is treated as singular and it takes a singular verb. Once again, let me tell you, when a plural number applies to distance, time, weight, or amounts of money and represents a single figure or quantity, it is treated as singular and it takes a singular verb. Let me explain it by an example. See to the sentence, 50 kilometers is not a long distance. The subject in the sentence is 50 kilometers and the verb in the sentence is. The subject, 50 kilometers, is a plural subject, but we have used a singular verb, is. We have not used are. It is because 50 kilometers is applied to a distance. Our rule says, if a plural number applies to distance, time, weight, or amounts of money, and represents a single figure or quantity, it is treated as singular. In this sentence, 50 kilometers is applied to distance. Hence, it is treated as a singular subject and we used the verb is instead of are. Some more examples will be like this. 60 years is a long time. 2 kilos of tea costs 600 rupees. 5 rupees is not a big sum. In these cases, the period of time, that is 60 years, distances 50 kilometers, and amounts of money, that is 5 rupees, are considered as one unit. Therefore, we treat them as singular subjects and use singular verbs. Next rules I will discuss in my next video. Dear viewers, if you are a student preparing for competitive exams, then follow the YouTube channel of Competitive Point Berhampur. They are doing a wonderful job of preparing the students in this lockdown period through their YouTube channel. Thank you very much for having this wonderful session. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Give your love and support to this channel so that we can deliver the best that we have in us.